This module is about FAIR data. My name is Max Heber. I'm a member of the University of Konstanz Open Science team. This module was produced in collaboration with my colleague Gabriel Schneider. In the next couple of minutes, you will find out what we mean by FAIR data and why you should use FAIR data. I will also show you how to achieve FAIR data and provide tips for your own FAIR data management. What do we mean by FAIR data? FAIR is an acronym for findable, meaning there are persistent identifiers such as DOIs or URNs. Metadata are available and stored in a searchable location. Metadata are additional information about the data such as author, year of production and such things, so everyone can contextualize the data properly. Accessible, that is, the metadata is always accessible using persistent IDs, using standardized protocols such as HTTPS to make them available via the web. For more information on persistent identifiers, please have a look at the corresponding module. Interoperable. This means controlled standard vocabularies and standard languages are used for metadata and relations between individual records are clear and explicit. Reusable. Reusable means there is accurate and complete metadata, clear licenses are granted, and discipline-specific standards are used, for example, regarding data format. Most of this applies whether your research data will be openly accessible or not, so even if you don't plan on publishing it for the public, following the FAIR principles has its benefits. The FAIR principles are a list of principles that can help you achieve these goals. Why should you make and keep your own data FAIR? Good findability combined with good accessibility increases the visibility of datasets. This, in turn, can increase citation numbers. It helps you make your data available for peers and the public. Additionally, if data are easy to find, research becomes more efficient because there is less unintentional duplication. This is true for published data as well as for data during the research project. Also, if you describe your data with rich metadata, people can reuse them without asking you for specifics. This saves everyone time. FAIR published data also generally improve the quality of research because FAIR increases transparency. The traceability of research results increases considerably if not only the publication itself, but also the data that go with the publication are made available. If datasets can be accessed publicly, new research questions arise more easily. For example, from the findings of a study. In this vein, FAIR can lower costs, as in some cases the reuse of data makes collecting new datasets unnecessary. FAIR data management fundamentally facilitates collaboration in the community, whether with direct colleagues of the research project or with community members all over the world. Having discussed the nature of FAIR data, I would now like to talk about how you can make your own data FAIR. If your data is allocated a persistent identifier, such as a DOI at publication, it can be identified uniquely on a global level. This makes your data findable and identifiable for everyone. As persistent identifiers don't change, you profit from this in the long run. If you want to learn more about persistent identifiers, also known as PIDs, please feel free to check out our module on this topic. It is a good idea to add other PIDs, such as ORCID or RAW, to your datasets so the data itself, but also the people and institution involved can be identified. In order for your data to be findable, you need metadata that is as extensive as possible, such as a description of the author, the project, the sample included, and such things. The metadata should be clearly linked to your dataset, for example, by naming the file name and location to which you refer. The amount and type of metadata needed will depend on your scientific community. It is helpful to imagine how you would like to search for a dataset and then to add this information to the description of your own data. Your metadata should also include a direct link to the data files themselves. The last point on findable data is all about having the information about your dataset stored in one browsable place. On your private computer, this may be the case for you, but another person usually cannot find your data there without access. As with a public library, the best way to store data is in a repository. You'll learn more about this in the module on repositories. Repositories send out the metadata on your dataset to other sources so it gets the best possible exposition. To make your data accessible to other people, you should use a standardized communication protocol. This protocol should be open, free, and universally used. It also should include features for authentication and authorization if necessary. A good example for this is the HTTPS protocol, which enables you to access data via the internet. By publishing your data in a repository, you fulfill this requirement. In some cases, there might be reasons to remove your data from a repository. However, even in such cases, the metadata should be kept available and accessible to others. How do you make your data interoperable, that is, easily exchangeable among people and or machines? Well, for that you need data and metadata, both with a formal, accessible, shared and generally applicable language for knowledge representation. There are multiple standards to make metadata available. You can again make use of a repository to allocate metadata to your data. The vocabularies and terms you use to describe your data should follow the FAIR principles too. Examples for this might be ontologies that are publicly available and provide persistent identifiers and definitions for their terms. If there are any other datasets, publications, or other materials that are connected to your dataset in any way, you should include references to those objects in the metadata. This can be helpful for other researchers to gain a better understanding of the research context. You can, for example, link to previous versions of the dataset or other files which are needed to interpret the data. Let's move on to the last point of the FAIR principles, reusability. To achieve this, you need data richly described with a variety of accurate and relevant attributes. This includes a clear and accessible data usage license. The Creative Commons licenses are a good solution for many cases and are used as a quasi-standard in the scientific community. You can learn more about these licenses in our module on legal aspects of open science. Clear provenance information. This helps users understand who created the data and when, and it helps them verify the data's authenticity. And as with interoperability, use domain relevant community standards. It is always a good idea to stay in contact with your colleagues and your research community to keep yourself up to date on how to describe your data in the best possible way. As you can see, some points appear more than ones, because with the FAIR principles, you can often kill two birds with one stone. If you hand over your data to a trustworthy, that is, a certified repository, this repository can help you comply with the FAIR principles. You can find out more about this in the module on repositories. Finally, I would like to give you some more tips. Create or follow guidelines on naming and storing conventions for your files, that is, in your workgroup, for example. If possible, follow the standards of your community as recommended in the FAIR principles. If possible, make sure to use open file formats, such as SAVdata. Tables can be opened only with SPSS, so it is better to use .csv as well. Well, this can also be used, for example, with R. This enables more people to use your data, as no licenses for proprietary software are needed. Consider training your colleagues and your employees in data management so that they can name and save files correctly from the start. These can be student assistants, technical employees, or students who are currently writing their dissertations and such things. Update and check your files and, if necessary, your DMP regularly and promptly. This may be somewhat tedious, but it's essential for a sustainable data management. It always pays off in the long run. Here are the sources of the presented module, as well as the image sources. Thank you very much for your attention and for participating in this module.